I solve some more examples on this projectiles. I have already explained how to derive equation of the path of the projectile, and we have proved that it is a parabola. And the four things formula are important. What are that? Time of flight, horizontal range, and maximum height reached by the projectile, that is particle, projectile, and maximum horizontal range. And also, while solving problems, you have to remember the equation of the projectile that we have derived. Equation of the projectile is y is equal to x tan alpha minus 1 upon 2 g u square cos square alpha into x square. That, and also in the derivation we have obtained expression for dx by dt, dy by dt. What is dx by dt? Component of velocity at any point xy. Horizontal component at any point xy is dx by dt. At any point xy, what is the vertical component of velocity? Dy by dt. And also position of the point xy. All these are there in the derivation. Now see, the problem is, if a particle, I dictate the problem first. If a particle is projected from a point O at an angle of projection alpha. If a particle is projected from a point O at an angle of projection alpha, and if after a time t the particle is at P, if beta and theta are the inclinations, beta and theta are inclinations to the horizontal at OP, and the direction of motion of the particle where at, means at P, then prove that tan beta is half into tan alpha plus tan theta. I think you follow the problem here. First I explain what is the problem. Say the particle is projected like this. It is projected like this. And what is given from the point O? Angle of projection is alpha. This u be the velocity of projection, and this angle is alpha. And suppose the particle is at a point P at some time interval t. After time t, particle is at P. Then what is given here? I draw the vertical here, PM I take. Now first is alpha is the velocity of projection. After time t, position of the particle is P. I take this as xy. At this point P, the velocity of projection, it makes an angle. What is the angle? Is it theta? Theta it is. It makes an angle theta. And also the, what is that? Inclination to the horizontal at P, and the direction of beta and theta are the inclination to the horizontal at OP, and the direction of motion of the particle where at. Means this is theta, and you have to join this. This angle is beta. Understand clearly. Problem is like this. The angle made by OP is beta, and angle made by the velocity at the point P, direction of velocity at the point P is theta, and initial velocity is u. Initial velocity with which particle is projected is u. It makes an angle alpha. Now theta, alpha, beta are there. What you have to prove? The relation between these three angles, theta, alpha, beta, is given by this. Tan beta is half tan alpha plus tan theta. For that, what do I have to use? First we use velocity at the point P is given by dx by dt, dy by dt. And also we have the expression for x and y. All that we have to use. So we start with this. U be the velocity of projection. And alpha be the angle of projection. Angle of projection means angle made by the velocity with horizontal, and B be the position of the point at any time xy, at the time t. Then suppose V is the velocity, this is V. V is the velocity at P. Velocity at P. Then say we start with these initial conditions, U alpha angle of elevation, P is point at any time D, V is the velocity at the point P. Then what are the components of this V? There V cos theta and V sin theta. V cos theta and V sin theta. Because this makes an angle theta with horizontal. What are the components of V? V cos theta and V sin theta. But what is V cos theta? It is U sin alpha. Because horizontal component of velocity is always constant. And it is U cos alpha, not sin. U cos alpha. In the derivation I explained, horizontal component remains always same. It is U cos alpha. But what is the vertical component? Because we have dx by dt is horizontal component at any time, any point xy. It is U cos alpha. And dy by dt is U sin alpha minus gt. Where you get this one? Go to the derivation. In the derivation we have this one. At the point xy, horizontal component of velocity is dx by dt and it is U cos alpha. Vertical component of velocity is U sin alpha minus gt. Since we have taken V is the velocity of projection at P, therefore V cos theta is U cos alpha, V sin theta is U sin alpha minus gt. So we have this, 1, 2. What is the problem here? Since theta, beta, alpha are given, this is required. We have to prove this. For that we have first this. V cos theta is U cos alpha. V sin theta is U sin alpha minus gt. I think all of you followed this. Why V cos theta? Horizontal component of V is V cos theta. Vertical component is V sin theta. But any point xy, what is the horizontal component? Dx by dt. Vertical component? Dy by dt. And they are given by this. Therefore, divide this, tan theta is, dividing, what do you get? Tan theta is U sin alpha minus gt upon U cos alpha. So it is tan alpha minus gt by U cos alpha. Correct? Take this as 3. Tan alpha minus gt by U cos alpha. This is 3. Further, what we use? We use this. Also, x is equal to, how do you get x? Say we have dx by dt is U cos alpha. What is x therefore? U cos alpha t. And what is y? Y is U sin alpha t minus gt square by 2. Correct? Gt square by 2. Because we have dx by dt and dy by t. Therefore, x and y are given by this. Now, see, this is beta. So, I take tan beta is y by x. You agree with this? See, this angle OPM, this is given, angle is beta. So, what is tan beta? Y by x. Therefore, tan beta is U sin alpha t minus half gt square divided by u cos alpha t. Now simplify this. Tan beta is, it is U sin alpha t is there, this cancels, U cancels, t cancels, tan alpha minus 1 by 2 gt by U cos alpha. Is it correct? U cos alpha. 1 by 2 gt by U cos alpha. This is, take this as 4. This is 4. Now we have these 3. 3 and 4. Now what do we have to find out? We have to prove that tan beta is 1 by 2 or what is the required result? Yes, tan beta is 1 by 2 tan alpha plus tan theta. How to get that? Tan theta is tan alpha minus dt by u cos alpha. And tan beta is this. Now I consider can I simplify this further, or I write tan beta minus tan theta is subtract. For how do you get this? Consider 4 minus 5. Almost we get the solution here. I think how these expressions are obtained. Now we consider 4 minus 3, not 5, 4 minus 3. 4 minus 3 gives tan beta minus tan theta is tan alpha cancels. What do you get? Minus 1 by 2 gt by u cos alpha. Correct? Is it correct? But you will not get this answer here. Tan beta once you have to simplify. So I write like this. Tan beta is 2 tan alpha minus gt by we take LCM here, 2 tan alpha minus gt by 2u cos alpha. Correct? Or just a minute, I write tan beta is multiply by 2, 2 tan alpha minus gt by u cos alpha. Now it is correct. We have tan beta here, multiply by 2, you will get 2 tan beta is, it is 2 tan alpha minus gt by u cos alpha. This is 4. Now consider 4 minus 3. 4 minus 3, what do you get? 4 minus 3 gives 2 tan beta minus tan theta is equal to 2 tan beta minus tan theta is, this is same, correct? This get cancels. 2 tan alpha minus tan alpha is tan alpha. Therefore, tan beta is tan alpha plus tan theta upon 2. This is the solution. Tan beta is this. Tan alpha plus tan theta upon 2. Next problem. Take this. If a particle projected from a point, on the level of ground and its height is h, when it is at a horizontal distance a and 2a from its point of projection, prove that the velocity of projection u is given by u square is g by 4 into 4a square by h plus 9h. I repeat the problem. A particle is projected from a point on the level of ground and its height is h, when it is at a horizontal distances a and 2a from its point of projection. Prove that the velocity of projection u is given by this. Now see, the problem is like this. At two points, the height projection, the particle projected may be at the same heights because shape of the projectile is parabola. Therefore, it is possible. Now, see these two points. At these two points, there, what is the distance? distance is, what is the distance? A and 2A. This distance is A and this distance is 2A, and these two distances, they are at the same height h. Take this as P, this as Q. Correct? P and Q. Now what are the coordinates of P? Therefore A, H. Because this distance is A, vertical is H. 2A, H. And velocity of projection B, U, and it should make an angle alpha. Suppose it makes an angle alpha. So we start with this. What is given? See, the problem is like this. A particle is projected from a fixed point O, from the level of ground, and at two points it is at the same height h. At two points, I have taken that as P and Q. At what points they are at same height, or the point particle is at same height? At a distance a and 2a from the point of projection, it will be at same height h. If the velocity of projection u and angle of projection is alpha, prove that u square is given by this. Now for this, we use equation of the path. Trajectory is, what is the equation of the trajectory? Y is equal to x tan alpha minus, x tan alpha minus, what is the equation? G by 2u square cos square alpha into x square. This is equation of the path of the projectile. See, in this problem, we use equation of the path of the projectile. Therefore, what is important? You have to remember that equation of the path of the projectile also. That should be committed to memory. You have to use this as a formula. Now, this is the equation of the path multiplied by 2u square cos square alpha. You will get 2u square cos square alpha into y is equal to 2u square sin alpha cos alpha into x minus gx square. Correct? Multiply by 2u square cos square alpha, or gx square minus 2u square sin alpha cos alpha into x plus 2u square cos square alpha into y is equal to 0. Correct? 2u square cos square alpha into y is equal to 0. So I take this as 1. This is the equation of the path of the projectile. Now, we know that at this P and Q, both the points, the height is h. So, I substitute y coordinate as h here. And what are x? X value is obtained by, if we substitute value of this y as h, we will get quadratic in x. And that roots of that equation are a and 2a. Using that, we get u square. Now substitute h, what do you get? gx square plus 2u square cos square alpha into h minus 2u square sin alpha cos alpha cos alpha into x is equal to 0. Correct? I verify this. Gx square, 2u square cos square alpha into h minus 2u square sin alpha cos alpha into x is 0. Now it is quadratic in x, and hence therefore gives two values of x, and they are the roots of the equation. And what are the roots? A, 2a are the roots of this equation, because here x coordinate is a 2a and they lie on the projectile. Therefore, this a, 2a are the roots of this equation. It is quadratic in x. Therefore, sum of the roots. What is the sum of the roots? We know that if alpha, beta are the roots of the quadratic equation, sum of the roots is minus b by a. Product of the roots is C by A. Use this. Sum of the roots is minus B by A. Therefore, 2u square sin alpha cos alpha 2 minus B divided by G. 2u square sin alpha by G. This is 3a. 3a is this. A into 2a. Product of the roots. What is product of the roots? Product of the roots is C by A. What is C? 2u square cos square alpha into h upon g. Cos square alpha into h. 2u square cos square alpha into h upon g. This is a into 2a. 2a square. 2a square. Now, take this as 2 and 3. If I correct, numbers are given are correct. This is 2. This is 3. Now, from 2 and 3, you can get u square. How to get that one? From 2 and 3, you will get u square. For that, take 2 by 3. 2 by 3 gives 3 by 2a is equal to 2u square cancels, g cancels, h is there, h remains there. It is 3 by 2a is tan alpha upon h, I think. Correct? Therefore, 3h upon 2a is tan alpha. This is obtained by 2 by 3. 2 by 3 gives tan alpha is 3h upon 2a. Now also, how do we get u square? U square is, we have this expression. What is that? 2a square is this. Take this 3. Here, from this, u square is, what is u square? U square is g into a square. G into a square. 2 cancels. I consider this now to find out u square. U square is g into a square upon cos square alpha into h. So g a square upon h into second square alpha. So g a square upon h into 1 plus tan square alpha. 1 plus tan square alpha. G a square upon h 1 plus tan square alpha. Tan alpha value you have to substitute this. 3h by 2a. Tan alpha substitute 3h by 2a and you will get the required answer. I leave this as exercise because of short of time. You try to solve this. Tan alpha you have to substitute. You will get